this is Anna at Nautilus Yacht Management. We are about to embark on a new cruising season in Fiji, and here is our first listing for the 2024 season. This stunning boat is named RORY. She's a 58-foot Bob Salthouse expedition cruiser. I'll tell you a little bit more about her. She was designed by the celebrated Bob Salthouse, who needs noise reductions for cruises around the world, and she was custom built by New Zealand Ray Johnson from the Johnson Yacht International. They specialize in building crafts capable of withstanding fierce sea conditions using only the finest material available and integrate a luxurious and exquisitely crafted and durable fit-out. RORY is built of 5mm carbon steel of a steel frame for a very strong hull and structural integrity in all conditions. She had a full refit in 2013, including a complete strip back of the hull inside and out, sandblasting and respray with 2-pack polyurethane paint over a high-build epoxy for thorough protection of the steel hull. She has no rust anywhere inside and out. She's had a full rewiring, plumbing with mast removed and full rigging replaced also at this time. RORY presents in absolutely immaculate condition, and we have a detailed service and maintenance record that you can request. We also have a health fitness survey available. Her decks are of superb quality teak in beautiful condition. RORY original owner wanted a boat that could take him to Antarctica. This is why he closely worked with Bob Salthouse and Ray Johnson Engineering to have a boat that could keep him safe in such incredible conditions. As such, not only her hull stiffness and strength, where obviously they're the first parameters for the build, but you can also see in the details of the boat inside and out. The high bulwark, the granny bars, the hand holes spread around the boat inside and out to keep you safe moving about in all weather. All the lines are run aft, she's equipped with electric winches, all the sails are furling, and her cockpit, which is situated close to the center of the boat, will keep you very safe and well protected in all weather. RORY is New Zealand registered with a Cat 1 offshore sailing certification. She also has a New Zealand gas and electrical warranty of fitness, which is current. It's hard to imagine looking at RORY in all of her details, from the deck to the rigging to the interior and right down into the bilges and the engine room, that this boat was built in 1990. One of the reasons why there is absolutely no rust or corrosion on board RORY is the attention that was paid to her electrical system. Her previous owner was a marine electrical engineer who paid very special attention to the electrical system on board, upon to the point of obsession. This was incredibly well done, and as such, there is no stray current and risk of galvanic corrosion, which can kickstart a rust process. And corrosion from the outside is prevented by having a really thick high-build epoxy and high-quality polyurethane paint, which insulates the hull against possible damage. There is really, it's a boat that doesn't show its age at all, and is a testament to how a well-built boat will have nothing to fear about aging, contrarily to fiberglass production boats, for example, who are built to a price point. In every detail, RORY is an astonishing boat that showcases the skills of many, many shipwrights who got together to build this boat at the very, very top of their skills and what the industry could provide in all times. To have a boat like this built nowadays would be close to impossible, or would cost something astronomical, which it did at the time. Her 2006 refit cost $1.2 million. And then she was refitted again in 2013, and then she was refitted again by her recent owner over a period of a few years, from 2019 to 2023. Her layout is really well thought of. It's especially designed for accessibility and safe use at sea. The galley can be used in all weather. You can brace yourself or lean against the side of whichever angle you are actually cruising under. The private master cabin is situated at the back and has an ensuite attached to it, so you can be removed from the crew and have complete privacy in there. The electrical system here is an overview of the switchboards. It's separated into three, 24 volt, 12 volts, and the 240. There is beautiful lighting everywhere. It's all LED, and you can choose whether you want to have regular lighting or night vision lighting if you're cruising. There's plenty of storage which can accommodate you as a liveaboard or for long-term cruising. There is two large fridges and one freezer, double sink. There is a double filtration system for your drinking water and the water through the boat with a double filter as you fill up the tanks and then another filter just for the galley water. Other comfort include a washing machine and a water maker. There's separate dinettes and a lounge area. There's two mirror image forward cabins, which are guest cabins and which share a forward head and shower area. Another great feature on RORY MHOR is the way that you can access every part of the boat. You can simply remove panel to check on the chain plates, or you can check on all of your electrical and plumbing elements. You can also remove the ceiling panels very easily to check deck fittings from the inside out. There is obviously no need to check on the keel bolts on this boat, as the whole hull is built with a keel integral. So you don't have to worry about checking on keel bolts, which could become defective, or keel joint, or have to worry about the keel ever falling out. Here's a navigation area. So the nav table is again designed to accommodate you in all weather, so you can safely rest and be there and check what you have to check without being thrown around the boat. There are repeaters down below and upstairs. The upstairs systems are all a very recent BNG electronics, which can be interfaced with your tablet or your phone, and which are through central wireless systems on the boat. You can have a look at everything just at the touch of your fingers, and even if you're not on the boat, you can keep checking the systems on your boat. For communication, there is a satellite communication, which is Iridium Go, which has this wired antenna, so you don't have to move it around to look for a satellite, and an SSB radio and a VHF radio. There is 10 fire extinguishers on board, and since the boat was used by National Geographic crew for a year and a half, as they were doing a series of documentary around the South Pacific, she had to be in New Zealand commercial survey. So she sees a boat that is actually surveyed for commercial activities in New Zealand, which has very, very high standards. They don't just approve any boat. They are extremely hard to get this certification. So this boat, which we can also send you, has a full documentation on the safety systems on board. RORY MHOR is now based at Naui Island Marina, which is in Savo Savo. It has recently been given preliminary approval to be used as a commercial charter in Fijian waters for the Fijian government and their regulatory body, MSAF. The boat has never been chartered, it's never been used commercially in Fiji. Pre-COVID, her owners purchased the vessel for chartering purposes, and as such have thoroughly explored and prepared the vessel for chartering opportunities. While exploring Fiji, the high demands for tourism-based activities were noted. In alignment with the significant investment and infrastructure in the marine industry in Savo Savo, Vanuatu in Fiji. However, due to timing, the current owners are now fully committed to a significant residential project in Fiji and reluctantly needed to prioritize. This is why the boat is on the market. But this provides an opportunity to take ownership of this extremely well-maintained vessel, either for ocean cruising and to explore a potential business opportunity for themselves, with a lot of preparatory work already completed. But talking about RORY MHOR's potential for commercial activity, it doesn't exclude that she's a boat that is fully prepared and ready for extended offshore cruising in all conditions. She has a life raft, which is in service. She has all of the electronics that you need. She has the storm sails. She has all of the safety items, such as jack lines and maneuverboard devices and EPIRB, and basically everything that you can possibly need to have this wide array of options for this boat. You can sail around the world. You can point her towards Antarctica and complete the voyage that she was originally intended for. And but you can also use her for as a business. In fact, we have seen boats like this do offshore cruises and tuition. So yeah, the possibilities are endless. RORY MHOR also has a very large fuel capacity, 800 liters of diesel plus another couple of hundred liters, I think, extra, which is stored in the lazarette or in the forward deck compartment, I think. And then there is also 850 liters of water. So that is supplemented by the water maker, which is a high output at 117 liters per hour, if I remember correctly. So that's really a lot of independence there. For additional comfort, the body is insulated with foam, so that will protect you against the cold and also against the heat. In hot and humid tropical areas such as Fiji, the boat is perfectly sound inside. There is absolutely no mold anywhere, there is no leaks anywhere. It's a nice watertight boat. And for the heat, you have plenty of portholes and windows to open for cross ventilation. It's a very pleasant interior in all weather conditions. RORY has an impressive amount of storage. Every area has something that can allow you to store something, whether it's on deck or whether it's inside, underneath the seats, underneath the floor. In fact, we will have a little look around to have a look in the bilges and show you how clean they are. Here's a little look in the storage area. As you can see, it's very well put together and it's super tidy. So there is no wasted space anywhere on the boat. So it's impressive how much you can store for liveaboards, extended voyages, but also to be fully independent. The boat comes with a full array of tools and spares as well, which we have listed in the inventory, which we can send to you. So again, comparing with the modern production boats, it's a very, very impressive difference. And you can see a boat that was built for the purpose of liveaboard and extensive cruising, and not a boat that can perhaps mostly accommodate coastal sailing and occasional use, and that somebody is trying to adapt to a more serious voyage. This was conceived with this in mind. Here's another one of the guest cabin. This one has a little bunk fitted out, which you can also do on the other side if you're required. All of the cabinetry is exquisite. You can see in all of the details the workmanship that went into this. This is a view looking aft from the forward head and shower area, which occupies the whole width of the boat in this section. So there's plenty of room and lighting. On the floor is a teak grid, which is really beautifully crafted, which is equipped with a sump pump, so you can shower and the water will disappear. And the toilets are both electric freshwater, so there is no smells, but it has an additional manual saltwater pump, which you can use if you were ever short of water or power. Looking back now towards the guest cabin, which so one of them has a bunk bed and the other one has a single bed, but you can easily fit another bed above this if you wanted to. The boat hasn't needed to have that many people on board so far, so this is the way it's been laid out. You can also remove the top bunk onto in the other cabin if you wanted to have something similar here. The boat has been given a full makeover even just in the last few months, so there has been full carpet removal and steaming, the ride works have been redone, the walls have been recovered so that it's completely fresh and in such condition that even the most demanding person looking for a boat out there will be satisfied. We're having a look in the bilges now, so you can see here is an example of how incredible the boat is maintained. How incredibly the boat is maintained. And the wiring, the plumbing, how sophisticated and tidy all of this is. The bilges are immaculate, and that's normally an area that boat owners don't really like to get around to look into. There is so much storage. Everything is really dry, and this is one of the reasons why the boat doesn't have any rust problems. The diligence with keeping the boat clean and dry is and also obviously the electrics and the plumbing, that's all come together to make this boat absolutely perfect and keep it perfect. So here is the engine room. You can see it's very, very large. It's very clean. It's really well lit. You can move around all your equipment to be able to service and maintain without having to contort yourself in all different positions. That was the owner generator there, and the Cummins 115 horsepower engine, which is superbly maintained and is a veritable working horse. It will push the boat at 10 knots easily. RORY MHOR here in all her splendor. She was originally designed as a 56 foot boat, but they decided on extending her to 58 to accommodate a swim platform, or we call it a sugar scoop, for easy access or for swimming or getting in and out of your dinghy. You can see the arch, the davits, the ridges, solar panels that are mounted onto it. She has very clean lines thanks to her boom furling system, which is means that you can just take out whatever sail you need. There will never be any problems for dropping it. And this boom also has an additional runner underneath it, where you can spread a nice big canvas sail sunshade. So that's a very good idea. So very sturdy rigging with a cutter configuration, and it has a double backstay on a hydraulic system, and it also has two running backstays, which are usually kept at the mast. But if you were on a hard upwind tack and you wanted to stabilize the mast, you can also add these on for extra security. If you ever have a problem with your rigging, you can also use that to stabilize your mast until you can have the work done. So in all of the aspects, this boat is really something that gives you an opportunity to set out solo or shorthanded with everything that you need here to feel super safe and to enjoy the experience. The boat also has a very good turn of speed in spite of her weight. She's 37 tons fully loaded, and she has the potential that you want to do anything that you want to do with her, she can give it to you. So we're very proud to present her to market. As you know, our company specializes only in serious offshore cruising and the cruising community, and a boat like RORY MHOR gives us a lot of pleasure to see that in today's day and age, we have boats like her who still exist. I mean, and there are very few boats in the world that can fulfill what RORY MHOR can, and that is in such impeccable condition. We look at a lot of boats out there and try to compare her with any other, especially steel boat of this era, and there simply aren't any, so we just can't find them. So she's available now. Her owner lives nearby. He's available if you wanted to organize a video tour, or if you wanted to just hop over and have a look. He's very, very knowledgeable. He sailed the boat from New Zealand to Fiji. He's on board almost every day, making sure she's kept in perfect condition. And he can, you know, through the process of purchase, obviously there will be a survey and sea trial. And we are here to help as well. So please get in touch. Thanks for watching.